Hi, Cubbies. Welcome back. We're so glad you could make it. Now, what's the first thing we do when we start Cubbies? Let's pray. To fold your hands and bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this evening. Thank you for all these Cubbies that are joining with us tonight. Help us, Lord God, to learn more about you as we go throughout the lesson. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. All right, Cubbies, now we're going to say the anthem. So take your right hand, put it on your heart, and we'll do the flag of America first. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Good job. I bet y'all did a great job. Next, we'll do our Cubbies flag. All right. Again, keep your hand. Oh, and don't forget to stand. If you're not standing, you're supposed to be standing. I forgot to say that. So stand up. Okay, now put your hand on your heart. We always stand when we say the anthem. All right. I pledge allegiance to the Awana flags, which stands for the Awana clubs, whose goal is to reach boys and girls with the gospel of Christ and train them to serve Him. Very good. Good job, guys. All right, we'll put that right there. Now, what's the next part? It's our song.
Cubbies!
Okay.
We are the Awana Cubbies. We're happy all day long. We know that Jesus loves us. That's why we sing this song. We hop because we're happy, and we jump and shout for joy. For Jesus is a friend to us, He loves each girl and boy.
All right, guys. Now, what's our other favorite song that we have our signs to? It's Jesus Loves Me. Let's do that now, okay? All right, get ready with Jesus. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to Him belong. They are weak, but He is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. I messed up a little bit, but you know what? Sometimes we mess up, and that's okay. All right, friends, I want y'all to enjoy these next couple of songs. Try to get up, stay active, and we'll see you in just a minute with our lesson.
You can thank God for making you special.
Aw, there's nothing special about me.
Who said that?
Me, boring little me.
Do you know Jesus?
Yeah.
Well, do you have Jesus living in your heart?
Uh-huh.
Well, then you're special. You're God's special child.
I am?
You are.
I am?
You are.
I am. I'm God's special child. I'm special.
And don't you forget it. Now, how about singing this song?
Yeah, let's sing. Can I start?
Sure, be my guest.
Just thank you, Father, for making me, me.
blue mailbox.
I'm ready for the mailman to bring me a very special letter.
Huh? What kind of letter, Courtney?
I pray for a letter from God.
But, Courtney, you already have a letter from God.
I do?
Yeah, it's called the Bible.
Wow, I'm going to go read this letter right now.
Yeah, I think that's a pretty good idea. I think I'll go read it, too. See you in a little bit.
Bye-bye, Gilbert. See you in a minute.
Oh,
Welcome back, Cubbies. Did you enjoy the songs? I'm sure you did. I always like songs. Okay, especially when they're with Muppets. Or puppets, rather. I shouldn't say Muppets, they're puppets. The Wuppets.
Uh-huh.
The Wuppet Puppets. All right, well, today is a review of everything that we've been talking about for over a month now, about the Good Shepherd. So today is a good review night. And in fact, our Bible verse is also a review. You've already done it, so hopefully it won't be too hard for you to remember it. Sometimes even reviews are hard to remember, but our Bible verse is one we had a couple weeks ago before Christmas. Okay, but we're going to talk again in review about Jesus being, do y'all remember? The Good Shepherd. And since I use these cards, I'm sorry, I will be going back and forth to the up to the camera so y'all can see them. But do you remember when we talked about the Good Shepherd? Every day, the Good Shepherd would come and take all his sheep out into the field. He would call them out of a pen, because sometimes more than one shepherd would hold their sheep there. And he would call them by name. He would say, Bob, Joseph, Annabelle, Mark, Alan, Jorge, you know, he would call them by name. And they knew the sound of his voice, and they would come running because they knew that was their shepherd. And the Good Shepherd would lead his sheep out to nice green pastures. Look, they're having a good time. Some of them are playing, some of them are eating, some of them are resting and sleeping. But every day the Good Shepherd would do that. He loved his sheep. He would stay right there with them, and he would lead them out to green pastures where they could eat and enjoy their day. Now, when the sheep got thirsty, what would he do? Would he take them to a desert? No. So, what is your mom or dad or grandma or whoever cares for you? What do they do when you say, I'm thirsty, can I have some water? They give you some water. So look, the Good Shepherd leads the sheep to water so they can drink, because sheep need water too. You've got the little baby one, got a little bowl for him. And the shepherd did this every day because he loved them. And every night, do you remember what the shepherd did every night? Every night, the shepherd would count the sheep, and he'd know them by name again. He'd count them 1, 2, 3, 4, until he counted all his sheep. And he made sure they were all there. Now, sometimes the shepherd would go too far from the pen, and he would have to take them to a cave like this one. And guess what? To protect him, he would sit at the mouth of the cave, and he would do that because the Good Shepherd loved his sheep. And so he was always there to protect them, day or night. Okay. Just like the Good Shepherd, Jesus is the Good Shepherd. He loves us, and he cares for us just like the Good Shepherd cares for the sheep. He loves us. He leads us to good things. But guess what? We have to follow him. Right? Okay. Remember a couple months ago we talked about how C is for Christ? So, how does Jesus become our Good Shepherd? It comes from us believing in him, knowing that we've sinned and that we need him to be our Good Shepherd. We need him to lead us, and we need him to save us from our sins. And he did that by dying on the cross. He died on the cross for our sins. And when we believe that with our heart, knowing that we're sinners and that Jesus died for us on the cross, then he becomes our Good Shepherd. But there's hope. You know what happened after Jesus died for our sins on the cross? We're going to talk more about this at Easter time, which that's my favorite holiday. He rose again. Look, he's standing outside the tomb. God sent the Savior. And he's alive. Our Savior is alive. He defeated our sin. And he is with us now. And he's with you now. Now, how do we communicate with Jesus? We do it at the beginning and end of every Cubbies. We talked about it last week. Whenever we're scared, what do we do? Now, I want y'all to think. I want y'all to say it out loud. What do we do when we want to talk to Jesus? We pray. That's right. We pray. Okay. And guess what? Guess where Jesus is at? Y'all remember this? This is from one of the earliest Cubbies we had. Where did Jesus go? He's in heaven. The Bible says he's preparing a place for us right now as we speak. He is preparing a place for us. Jesus even says, my house has many rooms. He's preparing lots of rooms for us. And what do you think heaven's like? You know, I kind of want to know, what do you think heaven's like?
I
put Miss Anna on the spot.
There's probably a lot of nature. It's nice.
Probably. I think that there probably is. It's full of the beauty and wonder of God. You know, if it's taking him a while to prepare it, I bet it's magnificent. But I think when I think of heaven, I think that we're with God. And I think that's the biggest separation of heaven and hell. We are with God, and in hell, it's like you're completely separated, and you don't want to be separated because that's dark and scary. But you will be able to see the glory of God. And think about what's the most magnificent thing you've ever seen. And think, that's just God's creation. That's not even God, that's his creation. Can you think about how magnificent he is? I can't, because my mind is so small compared to his. But I bet it's just absolutely amazing. But I want y'all to remember that that Jesus is the good shepherd. And really all we need to do is to profess with our mouths that we are sinners, and that we know Jesus is our Savior, and he died for our sins and he defeated that sin. And that Jesus is God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And he is in heaven now preparing a place for us. How awesome and amazing is that? And I can't wait until Easter and we'll talk more about that. But man, I don't know about you, but I feel great knowing that my good shepherd, Jesus, loves me so much more than I could ever imagine. And he wants to lead me to the greenest pastures and the best water, which, okay, not literally, because I don't eat grass, but he wants to lead me to good things. That's what it means. He wants me to have the best in life. And really, all I have to do is be like a sheep. All I have to do is follow him, seek him, pray, read my Bible, worship him, and look to him for a direction in my life. So you can do the same thing. All right, so our Bible verse this week, it's a review, comes from John 10:27. And it says, and I'll read it first and then we'll do it together, okay? It says, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. Do y'all remember that one? Raise your hand if you remember that one. Do you remember that verse? Raise your hand. Say, I do. Okay, good job. Well, we're going to say it again for our review this week. I'm going to say it slower. I want you to say it with me. Are you ready? Okay. John 10:27. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. Good job. Let's say it one more time. And then I'll show you the picture for this week for our worksheet. Okay. John 10:27. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. Good job, guys. I know you can do it, because I bet y'all are some smart cookies. Well, our worksheet this week, I don't think we have the print off for the letter N. Yeah, we can grab it. But while Miss Anna grabs that, I will show you the worksheet. I'll hold it up here. So, this week's worksheet, it has our Bible verse up here on the top. And down here, what you're going to do is you're going to count the number of sheep. You're going to color the picture, and then you're going to circle. Is that three sheep? Is that one sheep? Or is it two sheep? It's one sheep. So, color the number one. And you're going to do the same for that one. And that one, look, this last one, you can add your own sheep. I want you to add however many you want. You can put 100 in there if you want to, but you have to be able to write the number right there. See that line? That's for you to write your own number. And that, even more fun, it says color the sheep and the grass. And then the extra fun was to do the add your own sheep down there. Okay. And then what else do we have, Miss Anna?
For the letter is the letter N.
Ooh.
See that? Yeah. And there's Cubby, and he's... looks like he's giving balloons to Lovey Lamb. And the verse says, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. It means you should love your neighbor as yourself.
Yeah, thank you, Miss Anna. So, I can't wait for you guys to do that and to see you next week. But now what are we going to do? We're going to close in prayer. Miss Anna, can you do that for us?
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for the time here today. I pray we have a good week, and I pray that we grow closer to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. All right, until next time, bye, Gumbies!